A bright sunrise will contradict the heavy fall that weighs you down. In spite of all the funeral songs, the birds will make their joyful sounds. You wonder why the earth still moves. You wonder how you carry on. But you'll be okay on that first day when I'm gone. Dusk will come with fireflies and whippoorwill and crickets call, and every star will take its place in silvery gown and purple shawl. On that first night when I'm gone, you will reach for me in vain. You'll be whispering my name as if so. Life will call with daffodils and morning glorious blue skies. You'll think of me, some memory, and softly smile to your surprise. We'll both be fine when I'm gone.
Good afternoon, everyone. Ladies and gentlemen, I am Kenneth George, father of our dearly departed Keron George. Have you ever been touched by an angel? Well, I have. And I know that every one of you here and those watching on the video stream have been. Keron has been described by two of his cousins as always having an angelic presence since he was small. There is so much to tell about Keron, but due to time constraints today, you will get the short version. Our angel, Keron David Anthony George, was born on the night of December 27, 1983. His birth timing was as perfect as you could get. He gave us time to get over Christmas celebrations, Boxing Day, and the day after, before he decided it was time to put in an appearance. He was a loving child from birth, always with a smile on his face. He never cried, as most children in their early lives. In fact, the neighbors would ask if we really had a baby, for he won't even cry for meals, choosing instead to suck his finger and play with his toys in his crib, and only show his joy when we went into the room to check on him. We established our father-son relationship very early in his life, with him insisting that his last feed for the night had to be given by me. He refused to be fed that last bottle by anyone but me. Our relationship grew stronger and stronger throughout his life, and especially so when he went to Tobago to work. Tuesday to Friday were our chat days, and Saturday was a visit day in Kokie, where he lived. He was one of the lucky persons who got two sets of gifts at Christmas time, one for Christmas and one for birthday, at his mother's insistence. Keron left a trail of happiness with all whom he interfaced, whether it was school, work, or recreation. He was very kind, gentle, honest, and intelligent, all packaged with his trademark smile. He understood the meaning of sharing at a very early age and was never troubled when he had to do so. He was an avid chess player, and I believe therein lay his propensity for problem solving. He was always 4 to 5 moves ahead. He was a very good listener, and those of you who had the privilege to witness him at meetings or discussions, you would observe that he listened first, and only when asked for his opinion would he contribute. His response would always have a solution and not just a statement of the problem. His social life consisted of being a member of the Pacers family group of Kokie. He attended all activities in which we participated, especially Panorama at the Queen's Park Savannah and Calypso semifinals at Skinner Park. When he was younger, he and I would often attend cricket matches at the Oval and car racing at Wallerfield. He loved the steel band, chess, soccer, alternative music, and American football. And he had an insatiable appetite for reading. In his school days, he had established his own book exchange program among his peers and friends, thus widening the number of books he read. The digital age made this pastime even easier for him, as he could now download books at will. Video games was a huge pastime of his, and I would often ask, how is it that you knew what to do, since it seemed to me that there were no instructions on how to play. Yet he played and conquered game after game. In spite of all of the above, movies were his number one recreation. As far back as his university days, he was part of a group that made it their business to attend first night of any big movie. He would then inform his mom of which movies to look out for, herself being a movie fan. Within recent times, he picked up a new hobby, woodworking. When he got married, he found that the prices for furniture was not to his liking, and he felt confident that he could build what he wanted. He did his research, bought the necessary tools to get him started, and I dare say he built so many things for his home, dining table, TV stand, cupboards, you name it. Keron loved and respected his parents. A better son you couldn't ask for. He spoiled his sisters, Rayanne, who we lovingly call sibling, and Kristen, who started off being Weenie and eventually got the name Chrissy Chris. He spoiled them with all the love and kindness of a big brother until he married his love, Keisha. The love now had to be shared, and he found a way to make it work so that all would be happy. Keron's schooling ranged from Montessori School, Carapichaima RC School, Presentation College Chagonas, and finally Howard University in Washington, D.C., where he obtained his BSc honors and master's degrees in mechanical engineering, specializing in fluid technology, all this whilst being on scholarship. His spiritual life was second to none. From an early age, he was taught how to pray. He maintained his Catholic upbringing into his manhood. He was a member of the Panside of this very church and an acolyte and confirmation teacher at St. Paul's RC Church in Coover. Keron's gift-giving was always a huge project for him. Your gift had to be specially programmed for you. It included lots of research and choices until he was satisfied, and then and only then a purchase would be made. Whether it was birthday or Christmas or sometimes while shopping, he bounced up something that he had heard in a previous conversation, he always hand-delivered his presents, for he wanted to enjoy the moment when you opened your gift. He taught me how to solve Sudoku puzzles when I retired, since he wanted me to keep an active mind. It certainly could be intimidating at first, but he was able to show me that it was a patience puzzle and that you needed time to solve, and there were techniques to be employed in getting to a solution. One thing he stressed on was that there was only one solution to each puzzle. It is now a daily pastime of mine, graduating from pencil use to pen only. He was always very interested in what was happening in the home after he left, always making sure in his own way that all was well and that everything was being taken care of. Recently, he put permanent smiles on the faces of Keisha's cousins, Omari and Jordan. He took them under his wings with Keisha and tutored them for CSEC exams. From being unsure of themselves, he invested his time to ensure that they had a good base to spring from. They both excelled, especially in maths, admaths, and physics. In fact, he was the one who called me to give me the good news, so happy and excited he was for their success. His life with his wife, Keisha, was all about love, so much so that he refused his mother's offer of some palau on the last day time he visited, because she didn't have enough for two. They were a happy couple who only needed each other's company. Nevertheless, he kept up with his friends, either physically or via social media. Keron has left us with a void that only he was able to fill. His papa bear greeting to me when he visited home, and his call of Muma, to which his mother would reply, "Sonny boy," was no different the last time he visited, the morning of his untimely passing. In closing, this angel apparently finished his assignment on earth somewhat sooner than we would have wanted, but God knows best, and he has called him home. Keron, my son, Sonny boy, George, Georgie, baby George, whatever you call him, you will be dearly missed. We have only the fondest of memories you have left with us. We all loved you, and we pray that you are at peace with the Lord. May you rest in eternal peace. Thank you.
Good afternoon. I am Marlene Garving, and I am representing the Danos, the Charles, and the Garvings due to time constraints. Keron, as we call him, Kerr, officially joined our family in July of 2017. He fitted in like he had always been there. He maintained family relations, although he lived in Tobago for 5 days a week. He was always up to any adventure and participated fully in any activity we involved him in. To his wife, his mother-in-law, and his brother-in-law, he was a loving, dependable, and reliable young man. To Omari and Jordan, as we said before, he was an advisor. He was like a big brother. He was a mentor to them, a teacher, and a friend, and they will greatly miss him. He was instrumental, as was said before, in their being successful at the CSEC examination, and we thank him greatly for that. He was always willing to help us with any computer issues, and we had many. He was the life of the party during any family gatherings. He loved and supported his wife, Keisha, and their relationship was mind-blowing. You could always hear them say, teamwork, or we rode. You could talk to him about any topic. And we as the elders, we had a lot of topics that we needed to get cleared up. And he always had a solution to any problem. And he never forgot a conversation. He was a thinker. He was a listener. He always listened to what we had to say. And he was focused on any conversation that we had with him. He will be greatly missed. Rest in peace, Keron. Rest in God's heavenly arms.
Please stand. In the name of the Father, of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Praise be the God and Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, the Father of all mercies and the God of all consolation. He comforts us in all our afflictions and thus enables us to comfort those who are in trouble with the same consolation we have received from him. I bless the body of Keron David with the holy water that calls to mind his baptism, of which St. Paul writes, all of us were baptized into Christ Jesus, were baptized into his death. By baptism into his death, we were buried together with him, so that just as Christ was raised from the dead by the glory of the Father, we too might live a new life. For if we have been united with him by likeness to his death, so shall we be united with him by likeness to his resurrection. On the day of his baptism, Keron David put on Christ. In the day of Christ's coming, may he be clothed with glory.
Creator, loving.
My brothers and sisters, we have come together to renew our trust in Christ, who by dying on the cross has freed us from eternal death, and by rising has opened for us the gates of heaven. Let us pray for our brother that he may share in Christ's victory, and let us pray for ourselves that the Lord may grant us the gift of his loving consolation. O God, to whom mercy and forgiveness belong, hear our prayers on behalf of your servant, whom you have called out of this world, and he put his hope and trust in you. Command that he be carried safely home to heaven and come to enjoy your eternal reward. We ask this through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen. Please be seated as we listen to our reading.
A reading from the Book of Wisdom. The virtuous man, though he die before his time, will find rest. Length of days is not what makes age honorable, nor number of years the true measure of life. Understanding, this is man's gray hairs. Untarnished life, this is ripe old age. He has sought to please God, so God has loved him. As he was living among sinners, he has been taken up. He has been carried off so that evil may not warp his understanding or treachery seduce his soul. For the fascination of evil throws good things into the shade, and the whirlwind of desire corrupts a simple heart. Coming to perfection in so short a while, he achieved long life, his soul being pleasing to the Lord. He has taken him quickly from the wickedness around him, yet people look on, uncomprehending. It does not enter their heads that grace and mercy await the chosen of the Lord, and protection his holy ones. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Now overflows. Surely goodness and kindness will be with me all the way. The Lord's house for my dwelling, I will thank him every day. If I should
happy are those who die in the Lord. Now they can rest forever after their work, since their good deeds go with them. The Lord be with you. Reading from the Holy Gospel according to John. Jesus said to his disciples, "Now the hour has come for the Son of Man to be glorified. I tell you most solemnly, unless a grain of wheat falls on the ground and dies, it remains only a single grain. But if it dies, it yields a rich harvest. Anyone who loves his life loses it. Anyone who hates his life in this world will keep it for the eternal life. If a man serves me, he must follow me. Wherever I am, my servant will be there too. If anyone serves me, my Father will honor him. Now my soul is troubled. What shall I say? Father, save me from this hour. But it is for this very reason that I have come to this hour. Father, glorify your name." A voice came from heaven, "I have glorified it, and I will glorify it again." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Please be seated for a moment. My dear brothers and sisters, on behalf of our parish staff, I'd like to extend our sympathies to the family of Keron. We thank the Lord for life. We thank the Lord for bringing us into this world. There's a reason why he did that. Each soul is precious to God. Each person is precious to God. We may take God for granted. We may make excuses because we are faced with the challenges of the world, and the challenges will never go away. But Jesus says something to his disciples, all those who were his followers. Now the hour has come for the Son of Man to be glorified. And Jesus says, I am in each and every one of you. So the time has come for Keron to be glorified. What that means is that we live in this world, we practice our faith, and we are glorified by God. The kingdom of heaven belongs to us. But not all will enter the kingdom of heaven. That is a problem that we are faced with. We are faced with that problem because of the life that we live. We live it by what we say and what we do. But if we desire the kingdom of God, it is like a marriage. We see someone, we love them, we like them, we want to make friends with them, and we go on, and we have a little courtship, and we're going on, and then we say, darling, I love you, sweetheart. Too bad. Make up your mind. And she says, yes, I want you to. And that is how it goes with God. He knows us, and he invites us into a relationship with him. But the problem with this relationship is that we need to live according to how he wants us to live, according to what he has asked us to do, according to the pattern of life that he has called us to live. And he says, in other words, to do that, we are like a grain of wheat. Unless a grain of wheat falls into the ground and dies, it remains a single grain of wheat. But when we die, there's a rich harvest. What is the rich harvest? The life we live and the life we have left behind, how rich is that life? Because there are people who are going to follow how we live. Do you want them to follow you as you live? And that is what Jesus is speaking about. Dying to ourselves, putting on Christ, so that we live like Christ and we show that model and that example of how we are called to live. And we know in this world that is not true. Because many people are so anxious, many people are so angry, upset, many people want their own way, and everybody feels that they're all right and they're never wrong and they never do anything bad. And our Lord watches us and smiles. Did we follow his laws and his commandments? Did we follow who our God is, what he has called us to do? As he says in today's gospel, if a man serves me, he must follow me. Wherever I am, my servant will be there too. If a man serves me, not only say, I love you, but get in an intimate relationship with our Lord Jesus Christ. And he calls us to that intimacy whereby we can experience the love of God in our own life. that the challenges we face in life, wherever those challenges come from, are we the witness to God in the midst of those challenges? So we are called to that fidelity, to that faithfulness, to that commitment, that sacrifice. And that is what it means by dying to self. Giving up how we live, how our family taught us to live, how the community taught us to live, but not giving up on how God has taught us to live. Are we living the life that God has called us to? Are we sharing that life? And that life is a life of love. Not a love whereby we love those who love us, but we love those who love us and do good to those who hurt us and persecute us. And we have so many of those things in the world, but then we have to pray for the souls of those who have done these things to us. For vengeance is mine, says the Lord, does not belong to us. So here we are today. We are not celebrating the death of our brother Keron, but we are celebrating his life. And we pray and hope that his life will be one where the Lord will be thankful for how he lived and bring him to the kingdom. He was young, but his time has come and he has to go. For the Lord has called and he can't say, wait, I'll come in later. I come in next week. I come in next year. Each day is a preparation for our Lord's coming. And when our Lord comes, we have to depart from this world because he calls us to the next world. And the situation is this, as we are taught in our church. When we die, there is judgment. And where there's judgment, there's a journey to heaven or a journey to hell. And it all depends on how we live this life that God has given to us. But we also have to pray. And one of our prayers is always the forgiveness of sin. And we pray that the Lord will forgive him for all he has done wrong. And we pray that he will begin this new life in God as he has departed this world. May God find him peaceful. May God give him eternal rest. And may he experience the glory of God in the kingdom of heaven. In the name of the Father, of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Let us stand and pray. God the Almighty Father raised Christ his Son from the dead. With confidence we ask him to save all his people living and dead. And our response will be, Lord, hear our prayer. For Keron, who in baptism was given the pledge of eternal life, that he may now be admitted to the company of the saints, we pray to the Lord. For our brother who ate the body of Christ, the bread of life, that he may be raised up on the last day, we pray to the Lord. For deceased relatives and friends, and for all who have helped us, that they may have the reward of their goodness in the kingdom of heaven, we pray to the Lord. For those who have fallen asleep in the hope of rising again, that they may see God face to face, we pray to the Lord. For the family and friends of our brother Keron, that they may be consoled in their grief by the Lord, who wept at the death of his friend Lazarus. We pray to the Lord. For all of us assembled here to worship in faith, that we may be gathered together again in God's kingdom, we pray to the Lord. God, our shelter and our strength, you listen in love to the cry of your people. Hear the prayers we offer for our departed brothers and sisters. Cleanse them of their sins and grant them the fullness of redemption. We ask this through Christ our Lord. With longing for the coming of God's kingdom, let us offer a prayer to the Father. Our Father, who art in heaven, give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Amen. Please be seated. At this point in time, we have our offertory collection, which goes to the St. Vincent de Paul to look after our needy parishioners. Please stand. Trusting in God, we have prayed together for Keron. And now we come to the last farewell. There is sadness in parting, but we take comfort in the hope that one day we shall see Keron again and enjoy his friendship. Although this congregation will disperse in sorrow, the mercy of God will gather us together again in the joy of his kingdom. Therefore, let us console one another in the faith of Jesus Christ.
Into your hands.
Response to our prayer, we say, receive his soul and present him to God the Most High.
Receive his soul and present him to God the Most High.
Saints of God, come to his aid, hasten to meet him, angels of the Lord.
Receive his soul and present him to God the Most High.
May Christ who called you take you to himself. May angels lead you to the bosom of Abraham. Eternal rest grant unto him, O Lord, and let perpetual light shine upon him.
Receive his soul and present him to God the Most High.
Into your hands, Father of mercies, we commend our brother Keron in the sure and certain hope that together with all who have died in Christ, he will rise with him on the last day. Merciful Lord, turn towards us and listen to our prayers. Open the gates of paradise to your servant, and help us who remain to comfort one another with assurances of faith until we all meet in Christ and are with you and with our brother forever. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Our brother Keron has gone to his rest in the peace of Christ. May the Lord now welcome him to the table of God's children in heaven. With faith and hope in eternal life, let us assist him with our prayers. Let us pray to the Lord also for ourselves. May we who mourn be united one day with our brother. Together may we meet Christ Jesus when he who is our life appears in glory. This is the will of the one who sent me, says the Lord, that I should not lose anything of what he gave me, but that I should raise it on the last day. Lord Jesus Christ, by your own 3 days in the tomb, you hallowed the graves of all who believe in you, and so made the grave a sign of hope that promises resurrection, even as it claims our mortal bodies. Grant that our brother may sleep in peace until you awaken him to glory, for you are the resurrection and the light. Then he will see you face to face, and in your light will see light, and know the splendor of God, for you live and reign forever and ever. Ensure certain hope of the resurrection to eternal life. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, we commend to Almighty God our brother Keron, and we commit his body to the elements, earth to earth, ashes to ashes, dust to dust.
I will praise him on the land.
The Lord bless him and keep him. The Lord make his face shine on him and be gracious to him. The Lord lift up his countenance upon him and give him peace. Almighty God, through the death of your Son on the cross, you destroyed our death. Through his rest in the tomb, you hallowed the graves of all who believed in you. And through his rising again, you restored us to eternal life. God of the living and the dead, accept our prayers for those who have died in Christ and are buried with him in the hope of rising again. Since they were true to your name on earth, let them praise you forever in the joy of heaven. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen. Amen. Merciful Lord, you know the anguish of the sorrowful. You are attentive to the prayers of the humble. Hear your people who cry out to you in their need and strengthen their hope in your lasting goodness. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen. Eternal rest grant unto him, O Lord. May he rest in peace. May his soul and the souls of all the faithful departed through the mercy of God rest in peace. May the peace of God, which is beyond all understanding, keep your hearts and minds in the knowledge and love of God and of his Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. Amen. And may Almighty God bless you all, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Go in the peace of Christ. Thanks be to God. And as we take our brother's body out of the church, let us pray. May the angels lead you into paradise. May the martyrs come to welcome you and take you to the holy city, the new and eternal Jerusalem. May the choirs of angels welcome you and lead you to the bosom of Abraham. And where Lazarus is born no longer, may you find eternal rest. Eternal rest grant unto him, O Lord. Eternal rest grant unto him, O Lord. Eternal rest grant unto him, O Lord. And may his soul and the souls of all the faithful departed through the mercy of God rest in peace.
didn't know today would be our last, or that I'd have to say goodbye to you so fast. I'm so numb I can't feel anymore. I'm praying you'd just walk back through that door and tell me that I was only dreaming. You're not really gone as long as I believe. There will be another angel around the throne tonight. Your love lives on inside of me, and I will hold on tight. Not my place to question, only God knows why. I'm just jealous of the angels around the throne tonight. Always made my troubles feel so small, and you were always there to catch me when I'd fall. In a world where heroes come and go, well, God just took the only one I know. So I'll hold you as close as I can, longing for the day when I see your face again. But until then, God must need another angel around the throne tonight. Your love lives on inside of me, and I will hold on tight. It's not my place to question, only God knows why. I'm just jealous of the angels around the throne tonight, singing hallelujah. Didn't know today would be our last, or that I'd have to say goodbye to you so fast. I'm so numb I can't feel anymore. I'm praying you'd just walk back through that door and tell me that I was only dreaming. You're not really gone as long as I believe. There will be another rain. raised a question, only God knows why. I'm just jealous of the angels around the throne tonight. Always made my troubles feel so small, and you were always there to catch me when I'd fall. In a world where heroes come and go, where God just took the only one I know. So I'll hold you as close as I can, longing for the day when I see your face again. But until then, God must need another angel around the throne tonight. Your love lives on inside of me, and I will hold on tight. It's not my place to question, only God knows why. I'm just jealous of the angels around the throne tonight, singing hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. I'm just jealous of the angels around the throne His favor be upon you and a thousand generations, and your family and your children and their children and their children. May His favor be upon you and a thousand generations, and your family and your children and their children and their children. May His favor be upon you and a thousand generations, and your family and your children and their children and their children. Children, may His presence go before you.
go before, behind, beside, all around you, within you. He is me, he is me. In the morning, in the evening, in your coming, in your going. You're rejoiced, he is for you. May the favor, may the favor
be upon you.
Take me to the king.
to pieces. It's my offering.
A bright sunrise will contradict the heavy fall that weighs you down. In spite of all the funeral songs, the birds will make their joyful sound. You wonder why the earth still moves. You wonder how you carry on. But you'll be okay on that first day when I'm gone. Dusk will come with fireflies and whippoorwill and crickets call, and every star will take its place in silvery gown and purple shawl. On that first night when I'm gone, you will reach for me in vain. You'll be whispering my name as if life will call with daffodils and morning glorious blue skies. You'll think of me, some memory, and softly smile to your surprise. We'll both be fine when I'm gone.
A bright sunrise will contradict the heavy fall that weighs you down. In spite of all the funeral songs, the birds will make their joyful sounds. You wonder why the earth still moves. You wonder how you carry on. But you'll be okay on that first day when I'm gone. Dusk will come with fireflies and whippoorwill and crickets call, and every star will take its place in silvery gown and purple shawl. You'll lie down in our big bed, dread the dark and dread the dawn. But you'll be all right on that first night when I'm gone. Life will call with daffodils and morning glorious blue skies. You'll think of me, some memory, and softly smile to your surprise. We'll both be fine when I'm gone. A bright sunrise.
Gospel through the Lord shall not Christ, who has resurrected me. Praise the Father, praise the Son, praise the Spirit, three in one, God of glory, majesty, praise forever to the King of Kings, praise forever.
What do you do when you've done all you can do, and it seems like it's never enough? Can you tell me, brother, what do you say when your loved one goes away? Well, you just stand when there's nothing left to do. You just stand and watch the Lord see you through. 'Cause after you've done all you can, you just stand.
Tonight, your love lives on inside.
place to question. Only God knows why. I'm just jealous of the angels around the throne tonight. Always made my troubles feel so small. You were always there to catch me when I'd fall. In a world where heroes come and go, where God just took the only one I know. So I'll hold you as close as I can, longing for the day when I see your face again. But until then, God must need another angel around the throne tonight. Your love lives on inside of me, and I will hold on tight. Not my place to question, only God knows why. I'm just jealous of the angels around the throne tonight, singing hallelujah, hallelujah. Jealous of the angels.